2010 now, and there is a new battle brewing in the race for Wisconsin governor. Republican candidate Scott Walker is blasting the recent deal to bring a Spanish train manufacturer and more than 100 new jobs to Milwaukee, saying it comes at the expense of local businesses. 12 News' Ken Wayne Scott has the story, new at 6.
Spanish train maker Talgo announced earlier this month a deal to locate its first U.S. manufacturing facility in Milwaukee's old Tower Automotive site. In the process, Milwaukee's Super Steel lost out on the chance to build the trains and as a site for the new operation. Today, Milwaukee County executive and Republican gubernatorial candidate Scott Walker blasted the city and state for using incentives and tax dollars to shut out Super Steel and other Wisconsin companies.
And we should be doing everything in our power to support existing Wisconsin businesses before we start to give preferences, particularly to Spanish companies, both in the bid process initially and then in terms of siting that particular location.
But the city and Talgo say Super Steel was never a finalist for the site, and the city worked with local business leaders on the tower deal to keep the jobs in Milwaukee. Mayor Tom Barrett, of course, is also a candidate for governor, and a campaign spokesman said today Scott says he's for jobs, yet attacks the Talgo investment that will create hundreds of jobs in Wisconsin. This grandstanding just shows Scott Walker is a politician that Wisconsin families can't trust. Walker's Republican opponent, Mark Newman, blasted the cost of the Talgo deal and restated his opposition to spending millions on high-speed rail.
I would like to use the money for tax cuts because I understand that if we cut taxes, the people will take the money and it will lead to job growth and economic development.
Walker says he still has concerns about the funding mechanism for high-speed rail, something he says the mayor and governor have not addressed.
So the rail cars won't be built here, but Super Steel says it still hopes to be a subcontractor in the process. Meanwhile, one thing is certain, those rail cars and the jobs associated with them are likely to remain front and center throughout this race for governor. In Milwaukee, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.
A Talgo spokesperson told 12 News Milwaukee didn't offer the proposal for the Tower Automotive site until after Talgo had already ruled out the Super Steel location. The other two sites being considered were Racine and Janesville.